This is it, at last, the one you've been waiting for. In this video, I will show you how to take the code for the keys and the code for the whistle from the previous videos and fuse them to make a proper Meduino iwi. Let's jump straight into it. The wiring for the Meduino iwi is pretty straightforward. Each key is connected to ground on the breadboard and to pins 2 through 9 on the Arduino. There are jumpers for ground and 5 volts in the center, with their respective leads going to the ground and 5 volt pins on the Arduino. For the air pressure sensor, I can't really use the right angle header directly in the breadboard this time. So I've soldered together a small breakout board which lets me plug in the sensor like a mouthpiece. The breakout board gets connected to ground and 5 volts and to analog pin 0 on the Arduino. I've also used some cardboard from a box of garlic naan crackers to mount the Arduino to the breadboard with some wire twist ties. So with the Meduino iwi wired up and plugged in, it's time to prepare some code for it. First, go to my GitHub page and click on Meduino iwi here. Then video 56 and click 5605. Go over here and click this button to download the file. Now open up video 57 and click on 5705. Download that as well. And that's it for GitHub. Open up the Downloads folder and transfer the two files into a new folder somewhere else. I'm using 5801 Meduino iwi in my Arduino folder, but you can put it wherever you want. The code for the iwi is basically already written. It just needs a little copying and pasting from the two files you downloaded, plus a few extra lines of code I'll be adding in this video. I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code since it has this nice multi-pane feature, which will be convenient for copying and pasting. But you can use whatever editor you like. I'll be starting with 5705, so have that open in the front. First, the breath sensor constants. Copy these four lines and paste. Then the MIDI constants, which are these eight lines. And you can delete that gap right there. The open key note will be the tonic. That's this line right here. Now I want to switch to 5605 and grab these two lines. Inside the brackets, add 3 through 9 for the Arduino pins. For the key variables, go back to 5705 and select this line. Paste it and delete the two breath variables. Then add new note right here. Now I'm going to make byte variables for the left and right hand keys, LH and RH 1, 2, 3, and 4. For the breath variables, I can just hit paste again, and this time delete the two note variables. Then copy and paste these two lines below. Now it's time for the setup function. In 5605, grab the top half of the setup function and paste it in. Let's see. This will be for setting the pin mode. Now in 5705, grab the bottom half of setup and paste. I'm adding comments for note state, serial port, and the MIDI ready function. Close bracket, and that's it for the setup function. Now for the loop function. I'm gonna just copy and paste the entire function from 5705. I'll need to make a couple of changes to it, but I'll get to that in a moment. For now, I'm just going to continue the rest of the copying and pasting. I can copy the SendMIDI and MIDI Ready functions and paste them right here. The function to read the buttons will be coming from the debounce function in 5605, but I'm going to rewrite it a little bit. First, copy and paste. Now get rid of this int I inside the parentheses, change bool to int, and rename debounce to readButtons. Change all these state variables to buttonState instead. Get rid of this delay and wrap this line in a for loop. For int I equals 0, I is less than numPins, I plus plus. Tab and close bracket. Then instead of simply returning a high or a low, I'll put the high or low into each LH and RH variable. Don't forget to change this to button state. The I in the bracket becomes a 0. Now copy the whole line and paste it 3 times. Change these to 1, 2, and 3, and these to 2, 3, and 4. Then copy all 4 lines and paste. Continue numbering 4, 5, 6, and 7, and these L's all become R's. Return and I'll get to what this function returns in a moment, because it gets complicated. Back in 5705, select this little getNote function and paste it in. Delete this line and type int note new note. Note equals read buttons, delay 5 milliseconds, new note equals read buttons. Then for the return value, if they're different, return new note, else return note. And that's it for copying and pasting. Now, what does this function return? Let me walk you through it visually first. If I were feeling ambitious, I could manually encode a MIDI note value in a lookup table for all 256 key combinations. But that's lunacy. Instead, I will be using the magical power of math. At Gordon Good's Gordophone blog, there's a guest post by Johan Berglund explaining an alternative method of calculating key fingering positions, which he got thanks to a blog post by Brett Pimentel analyzing the key fingering for the Akai Iwi. In my code, the open key note is defined as MIDI note 60, middle C. Notes will go down the scale by either 1 or 2 semitones with each key pressed. I want my Iwi fingering chart to sort of resemble a flute, since that's what I'm familiar with playing. That means to program a simple major scale, I want to subtract 1 semitone with LH1, 2 with LH2, 2 with LH3, and for LH4, I'm going to add 1 semitone to get that A flat. Continuing the major scale with RH1, it makes sense to subtract 2 semitones to get F natural, but if I want to use LH1 and RH1 together to play a B flat like I can with the flute, I have to use a little logical jiggery-pokery. Instead of subtracting 2 semitones for RH1 by default, I'm only going to subtract 1. But if I'm also pressing LH3, and in this case I am, then RH1 will subtract an additional semitone to get the expected F natural. Then to finish the major scale, subtract 1 semitone with RH2, 2 with RH3, and 2 with RH4. This method offers some nice flexibility in the key fingering positions. For example, any of these combinations will play B flat. Here's how it will look in the Arduino code. Start with a tonic, subtract LH1, subtract 2 times LH2, subtract 2 times LH3, add LH4, subtract RH1, subtract RH1 again, logical ANDed with LH3, Subtract RH2, subtract 2 times RH3, subtract 2 times RH4. Simple, right? Finally, I need to make a couple tweaks in the note on section of the loop function. And I'm going to go full width for this. Whoops, that's not it. Close this and there we go. Okay, this is the note on section. I'm going to make a space right here and get a new note. If the breath sensor is greater than or equal to breath mid, then add 12 semitones to new note. Let's see. Then if new note is the same as note, I'll move Millis up here, tab this, clean this up, tab, and these brackets both get tabbed. Okay. Then if new note is different from note, set the note state to note weight and send a MIDI note off signal. And close bracket. This is the note weight section, which is fine. And note off is fine as well. Great. Now I can select everything, copy it, and paste it into the Arduino IDE to verify the code. Looks good. Upload the code and done. Time to test it out. I've created a flowchart that goes step by step through the code. I won't get into it here, but I'll have it available on my Hackaday page, as well as the fingering chart for the keys. I'm sorry this video took me so long to make. ADHD issues and budget issues and software and hardware issues, both with my computer and with the Arduino code. Plus my insistence on making all these fancy graphics for the video. Time just zoomed by, and I don't really have the best grasp of the passage of time to begin with, but now it's finally done and I can finally move on to the next step, which is using capacitive touch keys instead of mechanical buttons, and also using an Arduino micro with native USB so I don't have to keep using the MIDI serial bridge. If you've been enjoying this little series, I appreciate you hanging in there despite how infrequent my updates are. I do read your comments, even if I don't respond to them all. So thank you for writing, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.